Kevin Sorbo emerged as an international star in the 1990s when he landed the lead role in the TV show Hercules, The Legendary Journeys. During its six-season run, the series became one of the highest-rated syndicated television programs in the world. Since then, he's starred in several film and television projects, including Call the Conqueror and the 2014 hit movie God's Not Dead. Most recently, he starred in Gallows Road, a story of faith, family, and forgiveness.
Kevin, great to have you here today.
It is good to be here today.
Welcome. I saw Gallows Road yesterday. It's
Thank
a phenomenal
you. I'll be putting
film.
It up. This
yeah,
is good. We're putting
one.
It up.
And you and Ernie Hudson are phenomenal in it. Tell us about
Thank
the movie.
You know, it deals with forgiveness. That's what it really comes down to. Ernie Hudson's character, he suffers a huge, horrific tragedy where his wife and kids are killed. And he's hell-bent on revenge. Mm. And it's he's trying to find his way back to a better road. And he does that through other people that he, you know, meets throughout the movie. But my character is just, you know, he's a guy that's been down the road before. Gallows Road is basically just a metaphor of that road that many of us take in our lives. And we're going, you know, this is, I need to change my life. I don't like where I'm doing, where my life is. And do I have the strength to turn around and get off this road?
I think your character is the type of guy that a lot of people would like to have in their life, someone who can give wise counsel and has been there and is a very balanced guy.
Well, that's what it is. He's a mentor in a way. You know, he runs, you know, he's like a modern day cowboy. We shot this in Fort Worth, and it was a wonderful scripty part of it. It was written, directed, and acted by Billy McAdams as well, and he's one of the main characters in the movie.
It's a very powerful, emotional film on its own, but how does it tie into the times we're living in today?
Well, you know, you look what's going on in the Fergusons of the world and Baltimore's and all these other places, and you're going, okay, you know, the racism issue to me has gotten worse, and this movie deals with that, and it deals with, in a way, you look what happened in Charleston with the shooting there, and what happened, there weren't riots. People of all colors got together, and there was prayers, there was forgiveness, and I think that's sort of the road that God wants us all to go down, and it's amazing that the outreach that happened in that community after that horrific tragedy.
Great recent success for you with God's Not Dead.
Yes. Yeah.
Do you think that movie changed some hearts and minds?
Oh, there's no question it did. You know, you're looking at a $2 million movie that opened up the same weekend that X-Men opened up, which is like a $300 million budget, and we finished in the top two, I think, the first 3 weeks out, and they kept adding screens, and it stayed in theaters for over 4 months. I mean, this movie made close to $70 million
in the
U.S.
Were you surprised by that success?
I was, because I knew it would be a good movie. I had a feeling that it was pure flicks. I've done movies with them before. I highly recommend What If, a wonderful movie I did with them about 4 years ago, with John Ratzenberger and Christy Swanson. And I knew we had a good script. I knew what the director, Hale Kronk, was doing was amazing with it. So it just caught fire, though, because there was no really, other than you guys having us on, there was not a big publicity push for this movie. So it just hit a vein with people, and I think people are saying, you know what, we want more movies like this. We want movies that have a message, that have a positive message. There's a moral compass in there we all can follow.
How was it for you playing an angry atheist?
It was fun, because it was a different character for me. You know, he's so well written, and, you know, I have friends who are atheists and agnostics. We've had great debates and not got angry about it. But I see these guys that actually spend time and money to get on TV, and they're so angry about something they don't believe in, which is just, on one hand, I feel sorry for them. On the other hand, I find it so humorous. I don't get it. But it was fun to play that character and watch his growth as well in the movie.
Sequel coming out?
They shot a sequel already without me. So,
without you.
Without me.
Well, let's not talk
but,
about it.
Yeah, anymore. We won't talk about it then.
Very interesting, though, I learned about you. 13 years old, you go to a Billy Graham crusade and meet the Lord. What happened?
Well, you know, I was always a Christian, but I think this, I mean, you know, what do you know as a kid? You see things, and you see Noah's Ark, and they do these fluffy little pictures and the little cuddly animals peeking their heads out of the Ark windows. But when I went to speak and saw 200,000 people there, and I really paid attention, it was our Sunday school class that went. And, you know, I went up afterwards. I went up to talk and pray to one of the volunteers that work with him.
That's courageous at 13.
Yeah, you know, it was kind of interesting. I was very nervous, and I felt the Spirit of God working within me. And I've always been there. I mean, I certainly have done things that I'm not happy about in my life. And I'm not perfect. There are things I know God has forgiven me, but I have a hard time forgiving myself. So, you know, it's a road you got to go on. But I never lost faith. I never said, oh, it's all a bunch of myth. I've never felt that way about it.
Did you start to lose your faith, though, when you had some real physical problems develop that were very scary, I'm sure?
Yeah, it was. I mean, on Hercules, on the end of season five, I was having all kinds of problems with my left arm. And what had happened was there an aneurysm in my left shoulder that completely had been spitting clots into my arm, but it opened up completely, sent three clots in my brain. I suffered three strokes. So it was, yeah, I railed against God, I railed against humanity, I railed against life, but, you know, I like I said, my parents were there, my fiance was there, who I'm married to now, and there was a lot of support. I had a great support team around me, mm-hmm. and I realized it wasn't God's fault, you know, and the warning signs were there, and the voice was there saying there's something wrong. I just didn't pay attention to the voice, mm-hmm. and that was God talking to me.
And that experience probably you can look back on now when times are tough and remember how God worked in your life.
And you know,
a lot of us tend to forget what he's done for us.
That's true. And I think that experience, in fact, I know it did, opened me up to start doing more of these movies that are family-friendly, they're faith-based, they're not in your face, but there's messages in there like Gallows Road does, to make you think and maybe second guess about how and the way you're living your life.
And Gallows Road, forgiveness is a huge theme. How do you think that can relate to physical healing in our life as a Christian? What role does forgiveness play?
I think you have to find everything. I mean, you know, I've spent years, and I don't think a lot of people do, where you have a grudge, you have a hatred for something or somebody had done something to you in your life. It's only hurting you, because that person that you may hold a grudge against doesn't even know it. They're living their life wherever they're living a life. They don't know that you're still sitting there going, oh, I would just really wish I could do something. It hurts you. It manifests itself in you in ulcers and sickness, or it's something that's not positive for you to live that way, and it's a waste of time. It's like worry. Most of the things we worry about don't happen.
Yeah. Now, you're very outspoken about your Christian faith, and you enter into the political realm a little bit with some of your views. Do you get a lot of backlash for that?
Yeah, it's out there. But, you know, I'm at a place right now, I feel like Donald Trump. I feel like, you know, I'm saying a lot of things that people don't want to hear. And, yeah, I wouldn't want to run. There's no way. That's a horrible job to be in. I'm speaking my mind. I'm tired of what's going on in our country, and I've been tired about it for a long time. And I think we have to. This country is founded on Judeo-Christian principles, and we've moved away from that. And the mainstream media has done an amazing job of turning things around and saying, no, this is the way it's supposed to be. This country is built in individuals, not built in big government.
Mm-hmm. Well, you're quite an actor, too. Gallows Road, guys, I encourage you to pick it up. It's a phenomenal film, and you can get it at Walmart, Amazon, and plenty of other places.
GallowsRoadMovie.com also has the information of all the information on it.
It's gut-wrenching. There's some tough scenes in here.
There's some tough scenes,
it's real good. Thanks
Thank
for
you.
Being here.
Good to be
Appreciate
here.
It.